In the 21st century, when every other person uses Facebook Messenger, WhatsApp, Hangout, text messaging services, among other platforms, it is really easy to fall prey to writing in a way that ensures that your language takes a beating. There are many errors that we tend to make without even knowing that we are making it a habit to write a certain way, which is not the right way.
Please subscribe to the English Web and do not forget to click the bell icon to stay notified at all times.
In today's video, I shall be talking about some commonly made errors while using messaging platforms. The first mistake that all of us mostly make is using the SMS lingo. This applies to the abbreviations, acronyms, numerals, when you have to use words or slang terms. Even words like LOL or ASAP, they are not formal terms. Please ensure that you do not use any word which you would not use when it comes to writing on a piece of paper or writing a formal message. The second point is avoiding exaggeration. Now, I have commonly seen a lot of people use words like so and spell them out as S triple O or maybe more than one O. It is grossly incorrect. It really looks bad on your language when you exaggerate a word. Words like happy birthday, you know, people use a lot of A's in happy. If you want to stress on a word, then use bold rather than using more of the same letter, or use inverted commas if you want to emphasize. The third point is using unnecessary punctuation marks. People commonly use ellipses even when, you know, there is not really a break between two sentences. Ellipses is not supposed to be used anywhere and everywhere. Similarly, we also use a lot of exclamatory marks or unnecessary commas. That is not required. Please, like I said, avoid any kind of exaggeration, and that also applies to the punctuation marks that we use. The fourth point is avoiding one-word answers. Now, there is nothing wrong with giving one-word answers, if there is an urgent need to do so. But what I mean is that a lot of times we just tend to communicate using one word. One-word replies tend to become a habit over a period of time. So unless there is an actual need, if it's like a yes or a no, it's fine, you know. But if there is a proper reply that should be given, then try and answer in full sentences. I don't know, I personally feel that it really becomes a habit over a period of time to communicate like that. And in order to ensure that this does not happen, I think it's important to avoid using one word answers and try to reply wherever possible in full sentences. The last point is using incomplete sentences. Now, this is something that I have commonly observed, that when one person is even trying to use like a couple of words in a sentence, it still is not complete. For example, if somebody says, "Hope you are doing good." Now, that is not a complete sentence. We all know that the actual sentence should be, "I hope you are doing good or well." There are many other sentences that we commonly use. We all know that those are not really complete sentences, but we've coaxed ourselves into trying to believe that those are real sentences. They are not. Ensure that you write full, complete sentences. It's really important to preserve a language the way it is and not let it fall prey to the convenience of text messaging. I really hope that you all try and incorporate these points. I hope you all like this video. There are many other points that I would like to emphasize. I shall follow this up with another video where I shall be taking you all through some rules of using punctuation marks, some grammar rules. Do share any other points if you have any with regards to the errors that we make when it comes to text messaging. Do comment below and let me know if there are any other points that you have, and do not forget to share and subscribe to the English Web. I shall see you guys soon. Goodbye.